Hello, hello. I'm Juliana Haver, the plant-based dietitian, and this is the What Would Juliana Do Q&A. I've spoken over the years about vitamin D, and I thought I would concentrate all of these little facts into one handy video, and that is what I wanted to do for you today. Vitamin D is a pro-hormone known as the sunshine vitamin. Why? Because we expose ourselves to the sun and the UVB rays, and we are able in our bodies to convert that cholecalciferol via our liver and kidneys into the active form 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol. Interestingly, we are seeing a global widespread deficiency of vitamin D. Why is this happening? So many variables get in the way of that simple process, and let me explain some of them. Some of them are more individualized. The darker your skin, the more melanin you have, the harder it is to absorb the vitamin D. Likewise, if you have excess body fat, that gets in the way of vitamin D absorption as well. And then there's a lot of different really interesting environmental issues that you have no control over, like what latitude you live in, what the weather is like, how much smog you have. Now, if you're out there wearing sunscreen, you're not absorbing the vitamin D. And a lot of people stay out of the sun for good reason, because you're increasing your risk for skin cancer if you spend too much time in the sun without protection on. So it's kind of a real tenuous balance between getting enough sun and making sure you're absorbing it, and then knowing what's going on. So can we get vitamin D from food? Not really the best source of vitamin D. You can get it in, for instance, plant milks. All milk, dairy milk, and plant milk is fortified with vitamin D, so you can get some there. So also some mushrooms are now being irradiated, so you can get some vitamin D from there as well. However, is that enough? We don't know, because there is this global deficiency. So the most important thing you could do is know your levels. So I recommend all my clients get their vitamin D levels tested. It's not like a water-soluble nutrient like vitamin B12 is, where if you take in a little bit too much, you will simply excrete the excess. With vitamin D, it's a fat-soluble nutrient. So you have to be really careful, and you don't want to supplement if that's what it comes to. You don't even know if you need to supplement. So the first step is to go and find out your level. Many physicians are ordering vitamin D tests anyway, but you can just simply ask if you haven't had that done. It's good to have a baseline, and then it's good to stay on top of it, especially if you do find that you are indeed low. So once you know your number, if you are normal, if you are at a suffice level, which is about 30 nanograms per milliliter or 75 nanomoles per liter, that's considered sufficiency. If you're less than that, you want to try to attain those numbers. So you can try sun therapy. What is sun therapy? If you are in a good location, and again, this depends on where you are and the time of year, it really matters on a lot of different factors. Then you can try, if it is optimal for you, go outside without sunscreen. You could cover up your face, but without sunscreen and as much skin exposed without embarrassing yourself in front of the neighbors, I like to say, and get a little dose of vitamin D. Maybe only 5 minutes, maybe up to 30 minutes. You don't want to pink up. You don't want to get sunburned. That's where you do run the risk for certain skin cancers. So you need to be mindful and kind of play around and test it. And then you can see if doing that on a regular basis brings up your levels. However, this does not always work, so you may need to consider supplementing. A good baseline dose for supplementing for the general population, again, this is not medical advice. I highly recommend you talk to your healthcare practitioner, your dietitian especially, and it is about 2000 IU. Most multivitamins will have 2000 IU, and that's a safe level to consume on a regular basis. If you're significantly lower, please talk to your healthcare professional about doing a little higher dose, at least temporarily. Sometimes you need a therapeutic dose. If you're very low, doctors will prescribe a finite period of time, a very short period of time, with a very high dose of vitamin D, so that you can bring those levels to optimal, where they're supposed to be. Now, why does it matter so much? Well, there are associations between vitamin D deficiency and chronic diseases like cardiovascular disease and osteoporosis. And you've probably heard this in the news lately, there are some really interesting observations and associations in the literature already about vitamin D and risk for COVID and increasing mortality of COVID and the severity of COVID with a deficiency in vitamin D. So it does seem to be very, very relevant to even this current condition right now, along with all these other chronic conditions. So the first thing is know your levels, and then if you're low, try sun therapy and or consider supplementing. I hope that helps. Thank you so much for your questions and comments. Please keep them coming in the comments below via direct message or my website, plantbaseddietitian.com. I'll see you next time.